Welcome to the Climate and Water Outlook for August to October 2020. Two coastal lows in the Tasman Sea produced heavy rainfall along the eastern coastline, but much of Australia remained dry during July. A shift towards La Niña means wetter than average conditions are likely for August to October across much of eastern Australia. But first, let's look at recent conditions. July rainfall was below average for much of the country. However, two deep lows brought heavy rainfall, damaging winds, large swell and flash flooding along the east coast. Many places recorded over 100 millimetres in 24 hours, with three-day totals exceeding 350 millimetres at Maruya on the New South Wales south coast. July days were mostly warmer than average. Western Australia had some large areas that were warmest on record. Nights were cooler through central parts of the continent. With relatively low rainfall since May, soil moisture has declined across much of South Australia and Western Australia. But in the Murray-Darling Basin, soil moisture remains average to above average, a large contrast to the dry conditions this time last year. Some water storages are also in a better position than this time last year, with levels in the northern Murray-Darling Basin continuing to rise. However, storages in Tasmania and southwest Western Australia are lower than 12 months ago. So what will influence our climate in the coming months? Roughly half the surveyed climate models suggest a negative Indian Ocean dipole will develop during spring. But in the tropical Pacific Ocean, all surveyed models suggest further cooling. The majority indicate La Niña could form during spring. This would increase the likelihood of above average rainfall across much of Australia. The ENSO Outlook remains at La Niña watch, meaning the chance of La Niña developing in the coming months is around 50%, roughly double the normal risk. And a positive phase of the Southern Annular Mode, or SAM, may influence rainfall in August, shifting weather systems southwards. As a result, August rainfall is likely to be above average across much of southern Australia, but below average in southwest Western Australia and northwestern Tasmania that may see fewer fronts than usual for this time of year. With La Niña-like patterns expected in spring, the August to October outlook suggests above average rainfall across much of the eastern two-thirds of the country. The streamflow outlook for July to September suggests mostly low and near median streamflows are likely at 80% of locations. The forecast high flows are mainly expected in the southeast of the country. August to October temperatures are likely to be warmer than average, particularly across northern and southeast Australia. Last year, New South Wales declared the start of its bushfire season on the 1st of August. Much earlier than usual. This year, with more rainfall along the east coast, the bushfire outlook through to September indicates near normal fire potential for this time of year. So in summary, August to October 2020 is likely to see above average rainfall through eastern parts of Australia, warmer than average temperatures, low to near median streamflows at most locations, and near normal fire potential. Thanks for joining us. You can find out more about the outlooks on our website. We'll see you next time.